because of the important. So I think different, because the differences are rare. Differences, the sentient being who use mental sort of capacity, that I think we can call that a human being. So then, in order to utilize fully about human creativity nature, freedom, very important. So, when I enter here, you see, hardly no African people or Arab. I think in the future, I think such meeting, I think we should invite some people from Africa. That's a very huge continent, great potential. I often, you see, expressing when I met some African, because the person read, the Africa, such a huge continent, and huge, sort of say, the potential. And then, you see, the present sort of situation, that is very sad. So many small countries and fighting, and within the country, again fighting. And these sort of quarrel is carried by, suppose, those educated people. The people in the countryside, their real sort of effort is struggle for their daily survival. These are human beings. And then someone, you see, told, now the religious faith now causing problem. So these things, you see, I usually, you see, because of the call or express these terrorists as brothers, sisters. We should not, you see, put them something far. No, must bring closer. Then through understanding, I think firstly, the personal sort of contact, friendship, and through that way, we can develop trust. And with trust, we can touch these critical, serious matter never solved by distrust. And use force, totally wrong method. I often used to tell him, I love Mr. Bush since my first meeting. We immediately become close feeling. No formality. He really shows. Besides, as a president, he immediately shows as a genuine human being. Some other sort of president, sometimes when I first met, second meeting, third meeting, still, they emphasize more on present. Little distance. No use. Still present, even present, or king, or queen, or spiritual leaders, still human being. The number one, we are human being. On that level, no differences. As a matter of fact, I think today's a lot of problems which we are facing, with too much emphasis on secondary level of differences, including religious faith, and nationality, and color. In India, I think the caste system, I think the greatest obstacle is to promote genuine democracy, equality. I think that's quite serious. I think Buddha Shakyamuni, 2,600 years ago. You see, he specially emphasis against caste system. So even Chairman Mao Zedong, 1954-55, when I was in Peking, I said one time, Chairman Mao Zedong told me he considered Buddha Shakyamuni was revolutionary. Reason, you see, he totally sort of against caste system. That I think we can consider. You mentioned 800 years ago something. So I think 2,600 years ago, you see, one Indian truly committed the equality and against these kinds of the discrimination, right? So usually I describe Buddha Shakyamuni was one aspect, great thinker and great philosopher. And one aspect, I usually describe scientist, ancient scientist. Although this is not purpose, you see, some kind of because of that. Or teaching of Buddhism, no. Now, okay, full stop, finished. Democracy to human being is very essential. It's not only give freedom individual, but humanity, so as the further progress, the individual creativity nature must utilize fully. So in that respect, I think democracy, freedom, equality, these are very essential. And then I always see telling people, world belongs to 7 billion human beings. 7 billion human beings are real owner of the world. Then each country about Mr. Bush, you see, as a human being, wonderful. So as far as his policy is concerned, sometimes a little difficult. So one occasion after Iraq crisis happened, one occasion meeting, then I told him, I love you, I respect you, but some of your policies concerned, I have great reservation. Then he laughed. So this is a full sentence, okay. So therefore, you know, the democracy is, I think, the concern of humanity, not just one country or one continent. Therefore, each country belongs to the people, not a few individual kings or rajas or spiritual leaders. Sometimes I really feel the Bolshevik Revolution actually against the Russian, Tsars, strict of control. So against that. Unfortunately, eventually Lenin himself became like that. And then as well as the Chinese Communist Revolution, I think against the emperor's sort of extreme power, right? Absolute power, right? Then warlords, these things. And eventually they themselves become like warlord. So I think these things, you see, the worldwide movement, democracy movement, very essential. So as I mentioned earlier, you see, we should include some African people, some Arab people, then our meeting, our gathering, eventually, can cover whole world. That's, I think, very important. The movement of democracy is not concerned one continent or one nation. And this is because of the matter of humanity. Then this is our approach, not something, you see, try to or against someone. No. You see, we also, you see, we must keep the sincere concern of these totalitarian sort of people, right? Well, ultimately they will suffer. So sometimes they may feel a little difficult to change. Then our effort may help them to reduce sort of strict sort of what's the day because of the strict control. I think so we have plenty of reason to explain the totalitarian sort of system. Not much reason, short-sighted interest. Democracy, oh, for humanity, for a long future. So we have plenty of sort of reasons to explain. So I think real change, human mind, is an explanation. Use reasons, not by force. Reason with respect, genuine compassion, genuine sense of concern of their well-being. This is my belief. Whether right or wrong, you should judge. So, thank you. That's all. Thank you.
Oh, yes. I love questions.